Hey everybody, Bush on Speaking Force. Welcome to Weekly Technicals for the commodity dollars for Aussie dollar, dollar CAD, and Kiwi dollar, December 3rd, December 7th, 2018. And the COM dollar complex has certainly held up much better than the majors against the dollar, has held bid very well. We've been talking about for the last couple of weeks about how the Aussie and the Kiwi are really marking a very, very nice bottom on a longer term chart. Dollar CAD, of course, its own story, although did run into that big resistance between 33 and 34, as we noticed last week. But we'll talk about that in just a little bit more. Let's take a look at just the basic levels right now as they shape up for the week coming. Aussie still 72 support, but now 73.50 is the key resist here. 74 is really the big resist, but the 73.50 has been a sort of a claw that has been holding back the pair for quite a while. Dollar CAD ran into the resistance at 33.50, but it is perhaps the weakest of all, and certainly faces the biggest risk this week because we have the BOC on deck, which I'll talk about in a second. And Kiwi dollar really holding bid very, very nicely. The key thing here is, of course, the 69. If we can break above that, that opens up the full run, as I'll show you in just a minute. As far as the calendar goes, we have a smattering of COM dollar data from actually every currency. We start with the Australian RBA statement. That's expected to be sort of the least interesting because it's not going to make much of an impact, since they're going to stay neutral for the 25th or this 28th or the 100 millionth month in a row. We do have a little bit of bullish data coming up after that with GDP from Australia, which Kathy is bullish on. Generally, I think the data from Australia has held up well. None of it is going to have a major impact on how the Australian RBA feels about rate hiking going forward. The one mild positive thing that could emerge is if, as I'm recording this, we're now in the midst of the G20 negotiations. If Trump and Xi come out with some statement of agreement, nobody's expecting a deal, but if they sort of come out with some statement of agreement, and most importantly, if they can just delay the U.S. tariffs, the threatened U.S. tariffs of 25%, that could really cool and ease tensions on the trade front, which is naturally going to be Aussie positive and risk positive. So that could lift it a little bit more. It's been acting very well over the last week. I'll show you on the charts. And it's generally the tone that we're seeing as we go forward. Now into Wednesday, much more important risk is going to be the Bank of Canada rate decision. The market is expecting a no rate hike. The key thing here is the Bank of Canada going to communicate that they're essentially on pause for the time being? Data has not been good. It has really been soft. And most importantly, oil prices are $25 off the high, literally 33% off the highs. And I wonder if the Bank of Canada is beginning to worry about the massive crunch that's going to impact in Alberta and Edmonton, the big oil drilling areas of the region where credit could be a serious problem. Those are very capital intensive, very credit sensitive industries. And if the collapse in oil prices is going to create some credit crunch, certainly the Bank of Canada is going to want to stay easy. So it's going to be interesting to see just how sanguine Poulos is about all of this. If he is relatively dovish, we could see 34, perhaps even 35 break to the upfront. Canada has been weak for the last couple of weeks, and this is certainly not going to help things if the monetary policy is going to be turned dovish as we go forward. And then into the end of the week, we have the Canadian employment data against the U.S. employment data, same day. Market is looking actually for, here we go, essentially same numbers. We're not really looking for major. We don't have much of a, we don't have any estimates right now. But given the fact that GDP data was relatively soft, of course, the decline in the oil price is certainly going to have some impact in the oil patch. It's likely that we might have a weaker than expected employment data. All this just basically conspires to a potential move higher in dollar CAD, as we'll see. Let's take a look at the charts here, and we can start with Aussie first. Aussie to me looks really quite good. Let's go to the end here. So yes, Aussie is down today, but look at the very shallow retrace in the Aussie relative to everybody else, holding comfortably above the 20-period SMA. Yes, this 73 level has been a big resist level, certainly, but the 72 has been a big support. And any positive news on the Chinese front could really test us to the upside. Most importantly, I think, this is interesting, is that it's still a relative strength bid trade. Even it was this week, meaning that it was positive against the euro, Probably even positive against the yen, certainly positive against the CADI. And we're going to take a look at those trades in the crosses section. But for now, just keep an eye on the fact that this whole rounded bottom that we've been seeing for the last couple of weeks continues to perform well and still looks quite good. My apologies for all the noise. You should only know that I'm on the 11th floor, fully sealed in, and this is the noise that's happening because just construction and ambulances in New York City are just killing me. So hopefully you guys can hear me better as I scream over the sirens, but there's literally nothing I can do. It's fully sealed in, and this is the noise that's coming into the office. Hope you guys at least enjoy the slice of New York that is my life every day. Anyways, bottom line is Aussie looks pretty good. Definitely one of the stronger pairs. Same with Kiwi. Kiwi looks very much similar. Here's the Kiwi trade. Big, big round at the bottom. The 69 obviously stalled and we had a corrective move, but the corrective move really stopped pretty much 67.50, came back up. This becomes a very interesting level. Kiwi is actually trading better than almost everybody else. And if we can clear the 69 next week, it's a very, very big level. If we can clear the 69, close above 69s, it really opens the way towards the 70 as we move forward. All of them are trading, I think, better on the fact that there's an easing of trade tensions. The yields are still competitive against the U.S. yields, which have really dropped a lot. Look at the U.S. yields really right back down to 3. And for now, the best anti-dollars are actually the Kiwi and the Aussie. Now, CADI, its own story, and it's going to become a very much its own story next week when we have the Bank of Canada rate decision. So we're looking basically, we talked about the idea that 33.34 was a big resist point, and we're definitely butting our heads against it. But if Bank of Canada comes in dovish, if we close above 34s, that's a very, very negative construct for Bank of Canada, and it really opens up the way for a test of the 135s. Overall, still the weakest of all the com dollars, still the strongest uptrend against the dollar, and that's how the com dollars shape up as we go into the week. Wish you guys the best of luck, the best of trading. Boris Schlossberg, over and out.